Hi children, good morning. How are you? Are you fine? I hope you are fine. Okay, in our previous video, we watched about tanks. Okay, who constructed more and more tanks in our Telangana region? And what are the uses of tanks? And why the tanks decline in these years? This is the question. And types of nets, about fishing. So these are all you learned in your previous video. Now today the part two of this lesson, that is groundwater. Okay, the present topic is groundwater. Yeah, do you know what is groundwater, children? Okay, how it is known as groundwater? Yeah, I think so. You observe that it rains. When it is raining, the water, it flows on the earth surface, and some water is reaching on the drains, and some amount of water it percolates into the soils, meaning is at underneath soils, in that it accumulate or percolating in the soils along with the pebbles, silt, sand. Okay, that water is known as groundwater. The water that accumulate or percolate into the soil along with the silt, sand, mud, pebbles, that is known as groundwater. Okay, how we are getting this groundwater? Yeah, we are getting this water through the wells and borewells. Okay, we are reaching that groundwater. Later we all know different types of rocks. Yeah, here pervious rocks. The first type of rock is, that is pervious rocks. Some rocks having the pores or holes. Okay, if the rocks having the pores or holes, definitely it contains the water. Those rocks are known as here pervious rocks. Okay, but most of the rocks doesn't have any pores or holes. If there is no hole or pores, then how the water is entering into the rocks? So which of the rocks doesn't have the pores or holes? Those are known as impervious rocks. Those are known as impervious rocks. So in our Telangana region, we have the rocks like granite and the sandstone rocks. These, they doesn't have any holes or pores. And later, whichever the rocks, those doesn't have these rocks or such holes, those are called impervious rocks. And later I have to know what is aquifer. What is aquifer? Generally the lands next to the rivers consist of the deep layers of the silt, sand, mud, and accumulate with water and rocks. This is known as aquifer. This is known as aquifer. The capacity of the aquifer is depend upon the water. Okay, this is about water, pervious rocks, impervious rocks, and next one is aquifer. And next one we have to know about the water table. Take your textbook. In that, he has given water table. That is page number 28 has given the water table or groundwater level. You can see the diagram. In this diagram, he has given four wells, and these four wells having the same amount of water. Okay, same amount of water, meaning is this four wells depth is 5 meters. Okay, these four wells depth is 5 meter. Meaning is the water level is here same or equal. Suppose if you want to dig the well nearby this, any one of the well nearby, then you are getting the water in a same place. Okay, so this table has given to make you understand. But you know the children, the water levels never having the stability. Generally in summers, the water goes very deeper, and whenever the monsoon occur, if we have good rainfall, then water is comes up. So water never and ever having the stability. Levels are not stable. And later, what you know about them? What rocks and groundwater in Telangana? Yeah, already I told to you. In Telangana, we have what pervious rocks and impervious rocks. Pervious rocks which have the pores and holes and can contain the water. And here, granite is also one of the rock that is available in our region. And this granite has the pores only just 20 meters of the depth. Then water is reaching only above of the rock. Okay. But in some mantles of the Telangana region, we have the limestone. This limestone has a great cracks. So that more and more amount of water is reaching inside the layers of the rock. Okay. And here, the land that is just next to the rivers like Krishna and Godavari, generally having a what deep layers of the silt, sand and what pebbles and so on. And the water level in these lands depend upon the water in the river. Generally 5 to centimeters of the what depth of we can get the water. And here, these lands generally containing what heavy or plenty of water. Okay. After that, we have to know recharging groundwater. Yeah. Today's our topic is that is groundwater. So here we have to think about how to recharge the groundwater. Can we recharge the groundwater? How? Yeah, we can recharge the groundwater. It is possible whenever we have a good vegetation. What is vegetation? Vegetation is nothing but trees, plants and grass. If we have this vegetation, we can stop the runoff water and erosion of the top soils. Then water is percolating into the soil and the ground level waters are increasing. Okay. If not, if we do not have the good vegetation, then what happen? The water simply flows on the drains and on the surface. Then the water is not percolating into the soils. So then what is the use of such water? It can't use now. So that if you have good vegetation, then we can percolate this water and we can increase the ground levels. Okay. And as you know that, in most part of the India, we are receiving the rainfall only 3 to 4 months. Remaining months of the year, we are depending upon the ground level water. Okay. Even rivers, lakes, ponds also are getting the, are receiving the water from the ground level itself. Okay. And government of India and government of Telangana, they are having a programs about the increasement of the ground level water, that is watershed development program is there. Under this program, hilly areas, slope of the hills, they are planting trees and grass where the streams start. And slope of these hilly areas, they are constructing the dams and check dams to to store the water. Okay. In such a way, we can increase the ground level water. And later, quality of the ground level water. Okay. Generally, ground level water, it consists of various minerals. So that now, sometimes water is salty and sometimes water is very sweet. It is depend upon the minerals. And here, these minerals are getting from the rocks and soils underneath. Rocks and soils underneath. So, in many mantles of Telangana, having the excess amount of minerals like fluoride, chloride, sodium, nitrate and iron. mineral causes various diseases and damaging the bones and teeth. And some amount of water is polluted. How the water is polluting? Do you know? Yeah, the water is polluting by the utilization of the pesticide, fertilizers, utilized by the farmers. And some water is polluted by the poor drainage system. So, before we prevent this type of pollution, most of the rivers and wells and tanks became as unsafe for drinking water. So, government has to take the steps. Next, use of groundwater. Yeah, so far we are learning our topic, that is groundwater. Then how to use this groundwater? Yeah, this groundwater we got from our ancestors like a sacred asset. We have to utilize in a proper way. We should not overuse it. But some of the people, though they have huge amount of land, they are utilizing this water in over. Means in a high water they are utilizing. And the neighboring people, they are suffering. Means neighboring wells and wells that they dry up. If it is continuing, then most of the people, they have to suffer. So anyhow, this groundwater water we have to use in a proper way, because we got this from our previous generation, and we have to pass to the future generation. So future generation meaning is the coming generation. Otherwise, the coming generation definitely having the fights over water. And we are the responsible for it. So that we have to maintain how to use the water properly and have to tell our forthcoming generations also. Then they also use the water in a proper way and leading a happiest life. Hope you understood. Okay. So this is the present topic. And next topic in the next video. Thank you. Have a nice day. Stay home. Stay safe.